Hi everyone, my name is Eric. I am a former competitive figure skater, and this is my figure skating reaction series. For those of you who don't know me, I am a five-time U.S. National Championships competitor through the senior level. I trained for about 15 years in the Chicagoland area with top coaches, including most recently Olympic coach Denise Myers. So long story short, I know my stuff. Let's get started. So many people have been asking me to do an updated analysis video of Yuzuru Hanyu's quadruple axel after his attempt at the Olympics. So here it is. If you haven't seen the first one, my first video on this, which analyzes Yuzuru Hanyu's quadruple axel attempt at Japanese nationals a few months ago, please go back and watch that. I'm going to link that in the description box below. And so I'm going to use the same framework for analysis as I did in my previous video. So basically that is number one, speed, number two, entrance, number three, takeoff, number four, air position, and number five, landing. I'm going to play his axel attempt in just a moment, just a couple of times in real time and then also in slow motion so that you have something to reference to. It's honestly so hard to get some of this footage. Anyways, so you can refer back to it as I talk through my analysis. Guys, I need a haircut so bad, but anyways, ignore that. Okay, so let's start off with speed. In terms of speed, I would say that it was his attempt here was better than that at Japanese Nationals. It was a little bit faster. It's a really good speed, honestly. It looks like a speed in which he could potentially land the jump. And so at Japanese Nationals, it was just like a little bit slower. So I thought it was an improvement, really great speed. Yuzuru Hanyu really went confidently into this jump. Really shows that he is very used to attempting this jump at this point, even more so than before. So there was just no hesitation, and it really seemed like it's enough speed. So that was really great. Number two, entrance. In terms of entrance, it was really fascinating to me that Yuzu changed it just, you know, a couple months later from Japanese Nationals until the Olympics. So his entrance at the Olympics is more of an easier or more of just like a basic entrance that many people like do a similar entrance like that. Whereas the one at Japanese Nationals was more stuff going on. So which makes much more sense to me, honestly, for a quadruple axel. Again, obviously not that I've done it before, but logically easier entrances usually are used when you're learning a new and hard jump. So his old entrance at Japanese Nationals with the turns was very rhythmic. So I think that's what was kind of helping him. But honestly, it seems like with all the stuff going on, it would be in the edge pull and all of that, it would be pretty distracting from the jump and just make it a little bit harder. So I'm guessing that's a big reason why he ended up switching. This entrance that he does here still has really good rhythm and great speed, as I just mentioned before. And it makes it seemingly easier to get up into the jump, which was, I think, proven at this attempt. I think that there was something about how in an interview that I think Yuzuru Hanyu said that he went back, he was going back to his younger self's double axel attempt entrance or something like, sorry, not attempt, double axel entrance or something like that. Anyways, if so, that makes sense. It's a simpler entrance. More generic, not in a bad way, and just makes more sense for someone trying a quadruple axel, which is quite literally the hardest jump possible right now. Great. So I would say that he improved on that a lot as well. Number three, takeoff. So the actual takeoff in the air of like going into the jump is pretty similar, I would say, than his previous compared to his previous attempt. Yuzuru just generally has an amazing takeoff position on the axel. And so for all those people trying to learn their axels, whether it's honestly, even if it's a waltz jump, you could even use this maybe, but anyways, axel, double axel, triple axel, whatever you're learning, you should go back and look into that, because he's a really great really great axel in general and a great takeoff. He has a great kick through on the axel. He kicks really high. And I think I mentioned this in my last video, but it's kind of like the opposite of that, which is still viable for a double axel, is like a Yulia Litvinskaya double axel where there's almost no kick through at all. Actually, I think Kamila Valieva's axel also has almost no kick through, and she can still do a triple axel with arms over the head. So anyways, but in general, a kick through will make your jump bigger and like also make it more aesthetically pleasing probably. So Yuzuru Hanyu has a really great kick through and really steps up into the jump. It was a big axel, so takeoff was great. Next, moving on to air position, number four. His air position compared to before, it was better. It was a lot better, I think. It was tighter. Which is one of the big things I mentioned from the previous video. He's really tight in the air. There was less space in between his arms and his body, and his legs were really tight. So that kind of indicates to me that in general, when you're comfortable with going all out into a hard jump like that and pulling it as tight as you can, it means that you're comfortable and you're like ready to land it basically. Also, it's like kind of the Olympic moment. So I'm guessing he had that extra bit of, you know, energy and whatnot. But the one at Japanese Nationals, and maybe this was part of, some people say maybe this is like was like his intent, was not necessarily to like land it at Japanese Nationals. I'm sure he would have loved to do that, but more like get the feeling of it. And so here it was like going beyond getting the feeling. It was like, I want to land it clean. So it was tighter. So I think the air position was just much better. It was very, quite straight and like centered in the air, not really wonky at all. Maybe ever so slightly had that lean to the left side, which you can really see clearly when he falls and then goes over to his left side, which I think he does when he falls kind of commonly. But so you can see that basically when you're, the longer you're in the air, the more possibility of you to like go to one side or other. So the fact that he was almost like this is really impressive. And that's why it wasn't like a crazier or worse fall or really wonky or something like that. So that was really great. Really perfect air position almost, I think. I mean, I guess kind of just with the physics of jumping in general, he needs to be at least that smidge higher or smidge tighter to actually complete the jump. But it's just so hard because I honestly think a lot of that jump that we saw was nearly perfect. Moving on to the last piece of analysis, landing. Obviously, he fell. It was a great attempt, but he actually wasn't, in that specific attempt, he wasn't actually that close to landing the jump. Like, it was a very clear fall. It was one of those where as soon as you hit the ice, you know he's gonna fall. It's just how it is. And it could be partially, for example, when you try to get a jump cleaner and you pull in tighter, it can be hard to land the jump. Like, in some ways, it's almost easier to, like, stay on your feet if it's a little bit more cheated, maybe you two-foot it, which is what we saw him do before. But that just, it wasn't that surprising, but that's what it was. It wasn't actually that close to like physically landing it in that moment. And there was, yeah, there was just too much pressure to land it with that under rotation. Oh, my laptop. Okay. Anyways, overall, I wouldn't say it's really any better or worse. I mean, but actually if we're talking about rotation, it was better. You can go back and watch it in slow-mo however much you want. I thought when I saw it for the first time, like in, not in person, like live when I was watching the event, I thought it was gonna be like maybe a cue. But then now rewatching it, slow motion, blah, 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 all over again, it definitely isn't under rotation. So I think that was a fair call. It was just over the quarter mark. He was really close to the quarter mark, but it was definitely over it. And you can actually really see it in, I think, like that second slow motion video part. So it was really close, but it was still an under rotation 1 carat. Great. So after the landing, I would say concluding thoughts. Obviously an amazing attempt, obviously, probably one of the best and closest to clean attempts he has ever had and that anyone has ever had with this quadruple axel jump. So very, very commendable. Yuzuru Hanyu is constantly pushing our sport forward. That is part of why everyone admires and respects him so much, why I do as well. However, I do have one slightly hot take that everyone's gonna hate me for, but it is fine because I'm just telling my opinion. I low key think after doing a lot of rewatching, so you know, I've been rewatching. I've been using my third eye to really figure out what I think. I do think that Artur Dmitriev's quadruple axel attempt at the U.S. Nationals, I think it was a little better. I think it was. I said it right here. It was a little bit closer, a little bit better. I am not saying that Artur has a better quadruple axel than Yuzuru Hanyu. He just had that one attempt, as far as I've seen myself. I'm sure he's had other, he's had other attempts, but in the recent past, whatever, on footage, he has that one Hail Mary looking attempt. And then Yuzuru had that attempt at the Japanese Nationals and now the Olympics. Artur is actually close to landing that jump with the one carat with the under rotation, a small under rotation. He jumped so high, was so tight in the air. His landing looked wonky because he was going out of it, but like it was one of those where like he almost just landed it and then he kind of like went out of it. But Yuzuru's was like under down, completely fall, whereas Artur's was like, he could have landed that one maybe, you know? In terms of rotation, I think they were pretty much the same. Maybe Yuzuru's was slightly closer. I mean, at that point when it's like this and they're both under rotation, it doesn't really matter who has that little bit more of rotation, but more about, basically, they both had under-rotated quadruple axels, one carat, and Artur's was closer to actually landing it. So that's just in that specific attempt. So just my small hot take. By the way, link in the description box below for my original previous video about Artur and Yuzuru's quadruple axel comparison. But anyways, Yuzuru is the one that did it at the Olympics. History setting, hopefully trend setting. I really want to see more people do that quad axel soon. That'd be amazing. But yeah, honestly, I hope Yuzu keeps that he stays around and keeps pushing our sport forward and keeps attempting those quadruple axels or going for another Olympic podium. I don't know. We have no idea what he's gonna do, but hopefully he will. So yeah, I think that's all I have for today. If you like this video, smash that like button, subscribe to my channel, and turn on that notification bell. See you next time.